Welcome back for another beer review with me, Ruku. Today's beer review, and I've seen this everywhere, online, mostly Instagram, for example. This is everywhere. This is Volfas Engelman Baltic Porter. Okay. Baltic Porter comes foiled, which I like. This is a whole pint and comes in at 6%. Right, okay, I don't think I'm going to get it, but we'll try. There you go, 6% there. What I love about this is it tells you that it has... The bitterness is 25 EBUs. And it uses pale caramel. The hops are bitter. And it's the original gravity when brewing this was 14.2. So yeah, love this can especially. You can see there, and then it gets to this point where it's just like all of this map of Lithuania and Latvia and shit. It's just real cool. There you go there. So this is a whole pint can, 6%. It's nuts. On the map here we can see Latvia, Lithuania. And I'm guessing that would have been Estonia, but they cut it off. Yeah, it's just crazy. It even St. Petersburg, what the fuck? Like, St. Petersburg, you can't even see that, but there's like a bear and a crown St. Petersburg. I don't know what that's got to do with anything, but hey. Off comes the foil. It's, for those that don't know, it's a protector to keep the rim sparkling clean. So it just means that the storage methods are cleaner and better for us consumers. And there we go, just bears the name Volfas Engelman. Foil, silver, gold, gold, silver. Right, been looking forward to this and I've seen it a lot online, as I said. Can't wait to try this. I don't think I've had a Lithuanian porter yet. I've got no nails and I can't open this fucking can. Note to self, keep some nails because when you open the can, you're gonna need it. Okay, right. I think I'm there. That really hurt. Okay, Baltic Porter. There we go. There's your colour. Tandy brown, slight brown head actually. Yeah, I'd say two finger widths there. Small compact bubbles. Very, very tightly compact in the head. The colour, as we know, dark. Get it in certain light, it looks red. Other lights, it's black, so yeah. Crack on with the aromas. Just a very faint smell of dark malt. Very, very pale aroma. If I'm being picky, maybe the slightest bit of chocolate, but that's about as far as it goes. So a little bit disappointing in the smells. Hopefully it's going to be big on taste. So let's do this. Cheers everyone. Strikes me first thing. It's a little bit thin. The body's just a little bit thin. I know porters are generally quite thin, but this is, I would say, really on the thin end of thin. If there's such a thing. The head is foamy, it's expanding. I've got notes of chocolate, bitterness, hint of caramel. To be honest with you, I don't really get the roastedness from this, and that's a little bit of a disappointment for me. Very, very quick fading notes of chocolate. Doesn't really add much to the beer, if I'm being honest. What I'm left with on the aftertaste is puzzling. It's a combination of a very weak coffee mixed with, I can maybe put it down to like a hoppy chocolate milkshake. There's not really a lot going on. It's an odd one. It really is an odd one. I can't taste the alcohol in this, so 6%, forget it, can't taste it. Which is what the Lithuanians are good at, and some of the Polish for that matter. See, now the head takes on a different taste. Again, the head, I got a wort flavour. Very sweet wort. A minute ago, it was bitter. Now it's like a wort. It's a hard one. For me, I'm not sure if I like... Well, I like it, but I don't think it lived up to my expectation. You know, I was hoping something big from this. Like, I saw this plastered everywhere, and everyone's like, yeah, it's not a bad porter, and, you know, it's Lithuanian, and all this, and how good it is, and it just looks great. The can alone would have sold it to me. And again, that's why I bought it, because of the can. And I recognised it. I saw it from, you know, it was all over social media, and I thought, fuck it, why not buy a can? I've never had it before, let's do it. So I did. And I'm a little bit disappointed. I was expecting it to be one of those blow-you-out-the-water type porters where it's like, fuck, man, the taste is amazing, you know, it's big on flavour. It just really isn't. It's very watery, maybe a little bit too thin for my liking. The flavours are there, but again, they're very sort of weak. They're not... I've got a nice aftertaste, don't get me wrong, and it is a nice flavour, but for me, I just wanted it more stronger in the flavours. The flavours just didn't really come to life as I was expecting. And for the body as well to be that sort of thin, on the thin end of the scale, I feel there could be room for improvement, is what I'm going to say. Room for improvement. Not a bad porter. I would score this a 6.5 out of 10. But I would like to see just a little bit more from it. It's still worth a buy. If you see it, buy it. And I know I probably will buy it again. But for me, I just wanted something a bit more wow. And I didn't get that. So thanks for watching. I'm going to sign off. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share my videos. Join me on Instagram @RukusBeer for pictures of beer. And yeah, thanks for watching.